Hi everyone, it's Jen. It's Friday night at 5:15 on the dot, and it is the start of Summerween. So do not panic if you are participating in my summer colorween. This is a reading colorween that's going to take place from today until next Friday, I think. And I'm participating this time. And I was asked by a few people if I would vlog it, and I'm definitely going to vlog summer colorween. My event. but I'm going to try to vlog this one too, at least a little bit, because I do work during the week, so I can't just like vlog every day. So as I said, it's 5:15. I'm about to feed Snow White. Then we're going to take her for a walk. And then I have to bring my car to the mechanic because my check engine light came on. Of course, 2 weeks after we bought the car, that happens. So we have to go do that. That's really it. I have some reading that I'm going to do tonight. I'll show you a few Halloween-y things that I have. I'm going to start decorating probably the weekend of color summer. Summer colorween. I have a few things out. I have some Halloween lights up and a pumpkin, but more is coming. So stay tuned. Anywho, I'll show you what I have, and then we'll just go from there. So Home Goods has their Halloween stuff out of all the stores, like TJ Maxx, Home Goods, and what's the other one? Marshall's. Home Goods has their stuff out. So I got this cutie pie last night. Isn't that so cute? I just fell in love with this. I actually had another one in my hand, and when I saw this one, I was like, no, I need to have this one. That one is so cute. And then I got a new Ray Dunn one because I needed another one, like a hole in the head. But this one says happy, and it's orange on the inside. And on the front, it says Halloween. So I got those. Love them. And then I did take out my other mugs. So I have, these are the ones I drink my coffee out of every morning. Witch Please. I took out Trick or Treat. I just got that one last night, Pumpkin Season. And Witch's Brew. So those are my morning coffee cups that I use. Let me see. I also have taken out my mugs from my cabinets, or the ones that I keep in the cabinet. Usually I've been, you know, changing them out per season, but you know what? It's going to be Halloween 24/7, 365 here. Well, maybe not. Not on Christmas. Not going to be Halloween on Christmas. It could be, but probably not. Anyway, I have the Basic Witch. I have Hayride, Sweater Weather, Autumn something, Autumn Vibes in the back. I've got the Pumpkin Patch here. These are like my kind of regular mugs. My Harry Potter one, my Trick or Treat one is back there. I have my Pugs and Kisses, and I Long For You Dachshund one. I have my Halloween Zero up there, and I have my Christmas Zero. So that's what I have for a drinking apparatus right now. But I'm not going to be drinking anything because I'm going to feed the dog, so this is just the beginning, and there you go. Hello, checking in. So, still haven't read anything. Dropped my car off, went to Home Goods, found this feller. Oh my God, look at him. I love Home Goods. He was the only one they had. I'm so excited.
Can you put me in the
Got a place? Mug.
Hey, everybody. I'm gonna eat some Oreos.
We just went food shopping, and now we're going to go pick up dinner and then go home and unpack the groceries and then eat said dinner. Sorry, my hand was just in that. And then it's going to be reading time.
And then me my and guys, Daddy are going to play.
They're going to hang out. I'm going to read. I have to wash my hairs tonight, so tomorrow it ought to be just like a freaking disaster when you first see me, but that's okay. And then we'll see. We'll see what happens the rest of the night, and I'll see you at the next check-in. Okay, finally check-in time. It's 2:58. Finally sitting down to read. Oh, I did show this on Instagram, but I have on my Halloween pink pumpkin nails. Yes, so I'm very happy with those for Summerween. And I have Uber perfect special one for my event, which is also on my birthday. So I no cost spared, ordered exactly what I wanted. Can't wait for you guys to see them. Anyhow, I'm gonna start to read. As you can see, I'm 44% into Finding Clarissa. Really enjoying it. It's a young adult, I think. I'm pretty sure it's a YA
mystery book, which is like, if you've read The Good Girl's Guide to Murder, I think it's called, The Bad Girl's Guide to Murder, I don't know, one of those ones. It was a YA book with a red cover. It was really good. I really enjoyed that. And this one is so similar. I really like it.
I have my ghost blanket, which I absolutely love. Frank totally went out today at lunchtime and got this for me. He knew I had my eye on it, and he brought it home and surprised me with it. It's so beautiful. It's really heavy and comfy. Snow White is underneath it. Where is she? She's going to get pissed at me. There she is. Hi, Snow White. Okay, cover her back up. She's sleeping.
I also have my Radon yellow blanket on underneath here. I also have on my ghost pajamas because, you know, it's Summerween. And I have on a skeleton shirt because it's the summertime. And the shirt that matches these is a long sleeve shirt. It matches exactly. It's the same pattern and everything. But it's a long sleeve shirt, and it's way too hot for that. So, I mean, I have the air conditioner on. It's like 90 degrees. So there's that. I have my little pumpkin there. And then I have my fan here because I can't sleep without the fan. And then way over there is the Headless Horseman that I showed you guys before. I tried to focus in on this before, and it wouldn't catch it. It started to blur out. So that's probably as good as it's going to get. He's right there. And then I also have some Halloween lights up there, if you can see. There's going to be more for color Summerween, summer colorween. I keep getting that wrong, whatever. But yeah, so that's that. I thought I would also show you, like, briefly, the books that I have on my TBR, because I showed it in an Instagram post, but I never actually showed it here. So here's the thing. They have some prompts. I think they only have three, and I don't think I picked anything that fits the prompts. So the first one that I did pick was this one, Gallows Hill by Darcy Coates. This one is a review book. It's not out yet, but this is going to be probably like the scariest one that I have. So I don't know, obviously, what I'm going to read because I picked a few books, but I did pick this one. I also have another one by Darcy Coates, which is about a haunting. So maybe I might switch to that because one of the prompts is read a book with haunt in the title. Another one of the prompts is read a book with Halloween colors. I also did not pick anything that had Halloween colors in. And then I remember I got this one a while ago at some place called Book Warehouse. I think it was like an outlet store on Long Island. And I loved it, and I don't even know what it's about, but it's by Ray Bradbury, and it's a hardcover, and has beautiful pictures and illustrations inside. So, I mean, the illustrations remind me a lot of Nightmare Before Christmas. I don't know about you, but I have no idea what this book is even about. It was so cute as I started going through it. So I'm excited to get it, and like I said, it's got the Halloween colors. It says Halloween on it, and I thought that that might fit. It's also not very long, so I don't know where you could get this if you wanted it. Like I said, I found it at some like outlet store in Long Island. I also picked for my audiobook, I think it's called My Heart is a Chainsaw. I took it out from the library because I don't have any like audiobook services. I really just use the library for those things. So that one is a slasher, so I figured that one would qualify for a slasher one since I didn't actually pick one that was a slasher. Another one I picked was this one, Seance Tea Party. And obviously, I mean, this is a graphic novel. If I don't get to this, which is, it's like a middle grade, I think, graphic novel, so it should go pretty fast. It's about a girl who has a seance because she has no friends, and she gets a friend by the seance, and it's like her story. But it's very like Halloween-y and witchy and stuff inside. So, you know, I was like, yes, let's do that. And then so I put that on my list. I also have this bookmark. It was made especially for this. Bookmarks by Alicia. She made these especially for the event. This is the Summerween 22 bookmark. It's laminated, and you can write your TBR on here. So I might do that, or I might just write on here what I actually read when I get down to the end of it. And then it gives you the prompts right here, which was so cool, and then you can check off the ones that you did. So I love this. I bought one for Frank, too, because he said he wanted to participate in this, so we'll see if he does. I don't know if he's going to, but I have two of them. Another one I picked was this one, because this is one I've been wanting to read a really long time, The Paul Bearers Club by Paul Tremblay. I don't even really remember much about what it is about anymore, but it says, for a book, let's try to read this through the camera, shall we? For a book that looks death squarely in its sightless eye, this one is just brimming over with life and eventfulness. I think this is written like by, it's supposed to be like two people or something like that, and it's about a girl who knows everything about certain deaths and crimes and things like that. I don't know, it just sounded really up my alley, and when I bought it, the lady in the bookstore had already read it and was like super excited about it, so there's that one. And then the last one is one that I've already started and haven't finished yet. It's Anatomy, a Love Story by Dana Schwartz, and I haven't read that much of it so far, but what I did read, I really liked. So if I get the chance to go back to this one, depending on what I'm in the mood for, I figured this one is about, it's not like a slasher, but it is kind of scary. It's about digging up dead bodies and doing experiments on them and stuff like that, so it is about the dead, so I figured it fits in with this. So whatever I don't read, I can save for spooky season, which is starting now for me, so I have plenty of time until, let's say, like November 1st. So I think I'm going to make me a cup of tea, and settle back in here with my tea and my book, and have a little reading. I have my pumpkin candle. This is left over from last year. Mark your calendars. They say July 18th. The Halloween stuff will be out in Bath and Body Works, so you know I'll be there. I also got me these, because it looks interesting, because these say sour then sweet, new not so sour. So I'm not huge into sour candies, but I do like Sour Patch Kids. So Frank loves peach stuff, like sour peaches, so I figure if I don't like them, just give them to him. Also bought these because why not, but I almost will guarantee you I probably won't eat anything tonight. And I got this cute little mug at Home Goods tonight along with the Headless Horseman. So you knew I was going to go for this mug, didn't you? You knew it. So I just am letting the tea steep. I'm going to put my milk and sugar in it. Sit down and have a little reading session for as long as I can stay up. I don't know how long that's going to be, but if I fall asleep and I don't update you again, I'll see you in the morning. It's 12:06. I'm still reading, and I'm reading another one of the challenges, which is to read a book in the dark, which you can see I am doing. So I'm reading my Nook, which lights up, but I figure if I was reading a book, like a physical book, I would need a light to light it in order to read it, so I think this qualifies. So I've met a lot of challenges so far. We'll see how many more I can get done this week. But I will see you tomorrow on Saturday for the next updates. I hope anybody participating is having a good time, enjoying yourself the beginning of Halloween summertime. And I'll see you in a few hours. Good night. Good morning. It is Saturday. It is 9:09. I got up about 30 minutes ago, and I went outside and I fed the squirrels because they're waiting for me at like 6:30 in the morning. So I leave food for them overnight in their little squirrel box, and then they finish that. But so kindly, Frank got up early this morning like he usually does, because Snow White woke him up, and he fed and walked her, and then he fed the squirrels for me, and then he fed them again, because they eat everything, and now I went and fed them again and did all the things I do for them, like put out their feed and put out their water and all that fun stuff. And now I'm going to sit here while Frank makes breakfast, and I'm going to read some, because I really didn't get much reading at all done last night, so hoping to do some more today. I'm going to have to hear about my car.
Yeah, so I have to go find out about my car today,
and going to go Halloweening and probably hit up a bookstore and then hang out with my family tonight. I really want to watch Pet Sematary, and I know that's not part of the Summerween thing, but I can't constantly read. It's just not going to work. And nobody in my family, well, Amelia likes scary movies, but he's only 7, so he's a little too young to watch Pet Sematary. But I haven't watched it since I was probably 8 or 9. Probably my parents shouldn't have let me watch it that young, but there you go. So it is on Paramount Plus, and we have that. So I'm considering watching that later this evening with some snacks. I did try the peach snacks last night. I had like 4 of them, those little soury things. Those were really good. Didn't try the other stuff, so I can't tell you about that. So Snow White's here now. Okay, so Amelia wants to play with Dad, and Dad's making breakfast, so they're having a convo. That's what's going on out there. Anyway, I'm talking too much. I'm going to go read my book now and drink my delicious coffee. Isn't this so cute? This is my new one. This is what I have my coffee in every morning. So anyway, yes, going to go read now. Hello. So, Curly, which I'm glad of because it's raining now. Also, we are in Oyster Bay. We just went to this little hot dog stand called Bonanza. And I had a burp just then. And out right out here, right over there, is Billy Joel's motorcycle store. So let me flip you around and show you that.
You can see my husband's face. There you go.
There's Billy Joel's not his hot dog store, his motorcycle store, which is called 20th Century Cycles. And Billy Joel actually lives in Oyster Bay, or near here, Center Island. So we're just passing by Oyster Bay. Here's Frank really wants me to tell you this is the fire department
tournament team
March. Track for the drill team. So that's what that is. I'm sure he's played there one time or not. I think they had like an Inuk drill there one time that I went to. So we're driving down the block now. I'm going to show you the little hot dog place that we went to. It's such a cute little stand. It's like ices and hot dogs and pretzels and stuff. Whenever we come up this way, I always want to stop here because they have the best mozzarella sticks. So here it is. It's called Bonanzas. So if any of you locals, I know I have some local watchers, if anybody comes up to Oyster Bay, check out Bonanzas hot dog stand because it's really good. But make sure you bring cash because they don't take credit cards. So they have a little place in the back that you could actually sit at and have your hot dogs. So I got my car back. It was something simple. It was that, I guess, the good old boy here left the gas cap a little bit open, and it just set off the sensor. So luckily nothing else was wrong. So got the car back. We're in the car, left the other car at home. There's my boy back there. He's all full of hot dogs and mozzarella sticks. Got Snow White here, Frankie there. And now we're going to another Home Goods. We went to one Home Goods. I got a pillow, which I'll show you later. We're going to go Halloweening. And I'm not doing any reading at all today, unfortunately. Emilio's got it.
And Jen bought this pillow that glows.
Yes, it glows in the dark. Isn't that cute? Get that at Home Goods. So I'll have to put that on the couch later. Cute. So that's what we're doing. Maybe we'll hit up a bookstore. We just fed Snow White a hot dog, so we don't have to go home to feed her. She's good. And we'll take you more on our travels. I didn't film in the last Home Goods because I actually went in there alone because it was like super crowded. And it would have been like really weird filming in there with all those people. So hopefully when we get to the next one, because I'm on a mission to find something, when we get to the next one, we'll all be together and I can show you a little bit of the Halloween goods.
And it seems like only Home Goods has the stuff. It's like heaven.
this is what we call Halloweening. Going shopping for goodies before Halloween comes.
Way before Halloween comes.
We have already done Halloween bowls. What reading weekend would not be complete without a trip to my favorite store?
So it's almost 9 o'clock now. We're still out and we came down to this place called Captree where they have lots of boats and fishing, and they have a party boat tonight with some live music. So my son wanted to check it out, so we're here just seeing what's going on. So I'll show you.
There's Amelia, right? I can't see right there. There's the party boat.
I'm sitting in the car with Snow White. You can't really see her too much. I also have my Nook here because I bring a book with me everywhere I go just in case the opportunity ever arises for me to read. Snow White's head is in the camera. I have a Starbucks, a large latte, even though it's 9:20 at night. I intend on staying up to read tonight because I really didn't stay up too much last night. So that's what I'm doing. So I just thought I'd check in. Cheers.
Last check-in of the night. It is 12:15 a.m. I'm cuddled up on my reading couch that we got specifically for me for reading and coloring, which I really only do reading on and mostly sleeping on these days. But I have my book. I have this cute, adorable pillow. I think Amelia showed it to you before. He glows in the dark. So he's going to be my little pillow to hold my book. I have my ghosty blanket. And then the thing that I went out searching for today, Halloweening, was this guy. So that's my fan there. Amelia was asleep on the couch, so I have to be kind of quiet. But here's Ghosty, and he's a cute little pillow, so I'm very happy with him. He's propping me up here, and I'm set now for a little bit anyway while I read. I have my Halloween lights on up there. I have to be quiet. I'm waking up Amelia. So I'm going to say goodnight and I'll see you for Summerween day 3 tomorrow. Goodnight.
Good morning. Summerween day 3. It is Sunday morning. I am not reading. I'm coloring because my little friend, my coloring assistant, my reading assistant there, he wanted to color this morning. So we are having some coloring time together, and I'm watching, oh gosh, what's her name? Alexandra Roslin's Summerween video day 1. So there's that. Also having my coffee, my pumpkin season mug or cup or whatever, and still in my PJs, but that was because, like I told you, I took a shower last night when we came home. So I am clean. I just have to change my clothes later at some point. So one of the prompts for this is to make a sweet treat. So I think I'm going to make these because it's just easier than baking a cake, because that's just going to take much of my time. And that's one of the prompts for Summer Colorween, is to make a fall treat. So I'll be making another treat in
a little over a week, and I will be baking like a cake thing for that. So I'm gonna make these because why not? And I'm gonna get back to coloring for a little bit, and then I will be reading. Let me show you. I set up my little reading area here so you can see. And I'm all set for reading for whenever I get that chance to do that. So I'm going to go make those cookies and see you in a bit. All right, they're done. Unfortunately, the bottom row all became one. They got really huge, and they don't usually do that, the ones that you just buy from the store. My experience has been they spread a little, but not so much, and I had more than enough room on the pan for them, but whatever. I took the knife and went around them. They don't have to be perfect. They're all going to the same place. That's what my dad used to say. So they have to cool for like 3 minutes, and then I will try one with my coffee because, you know, it's, what, 9:43, and it's time for cookies. So this coloring assistant's done coloring for now, so I think I'm going to be done coloring for now and go back to reading my book.
Please don't mind my haggard look in the morning. Cinnamon Toast Crunch cookies. Clutch. So good. Get them. Good morning, everyone. It's Wednesday morning, and the reason I just decided to do this was because I never actually closed out my vlog from the other day. I filmed a whole bunch over the weekend. I put the vlog together yesterday, and then I was considering to add Friday into it, but I don't know what this weekend's gonna bring, and I don't know how much actual reading I'll get done on Friday because, you know, it is a work day for me still, and today's a work day for me. But I thought I'd just film this really quick ending to say I hope that you enjoyed my Summerween weekend. I'm still reading. I'm still reading, actually, Finding Clarissa. The last few nights I've actually taken a break from reading. I've been watching some like scary, spooky stuff on YouTube, so there's that. If you want to know what I'm watching, so it is in the Halloween theme type thing. It's the Ed and Lorraine Warren Museum. There was some investigators that went there recently, or they put up their video recently. So I was watching that. It's like the actual Annabelle doll and other kind of weird things. Really enjoying it. I think it's like in four parts. So I watched two parts yesterday, and I'll probably watch two parts today. But yeah, really enjoying that. So that's what I've been doing. Not reading too much, just a little bit, like a half an hour here and there. But Amelia and I did go to Bath & Body Works, and I picked up a few of the Halloween things because they did come out on Monday. So if you've not been or haven't shopped online, look either in-store or online. They have their Halloween stuff. So I will show you what I got and just say thank you so much for watching this. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm really looking forward to Summer Colorween coming up July 29th. Mark your calendars. I will be live streaming that night. It's a Friday night, so I will be live streaming that night. I'm also going to be coming out with a video for you guys telling you how to get the free coloring page that Deborah Muller created especially for Summer Colorween. So stay tuned for that here on YouTube, or you can look at Instagram. I will have that going up this week. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.
Just quickly, these are the things we got. So Amelia wanted this guy. He's a sanitizer holder. His eyes light up, maybe. Can I do it with this hand? My hands are so weak. It's really hard for me to push buttons and do stuff. I cannot do this at all. Okay, this doesn't work. Oh, I got it. Oh boy. So his eyes light up, and he also glows in the dark, and he really does glow, I have to say. When we came in the house, we were shocked to see how much he glows. Look at his green eyes. How cool is that? Or maybe that's just the inside of it glowing because the lights went out. So yeah, that's what it is. So it's not actually green. It's just the glow-in-the-dark glowing. Okay, and he comes on a chain. I got this hand sanitizer holder, and I wanted to go to the store to actually look at this to see what it actually looked like before I bought it, to see if it was like cheesy or not. And the camera's not picking it up, but it's really cute. Even Frank liked that one. And then Emilio found this one for me. This is like hands with like a witch hand with nails, and it's a sanitizer holder. I got a bunch of the pumpkin cupcake sanitizer because that's our favorite one. We use that almost all year long. So I bought like five of them.
they didn't have very many, and they hardly had any of the fall sanitizers. I mean, they're just putting their stuff out, so it's going to be more stuff coming out. And then I also got two of the pumpkin carving candles. Those are my favorite. So when they go on sale, I shall be stocking up. But they're not on sale right now, so I really didn't want to go overboard because they're $25. So when they go on sale for half price, I'll be stocking up on those because I like those for the entire Halloween season. And then I did start this book. I'm liking it. It's a nice little like children's book. It's called The Halloween Tree. I showed this to you guys in the previous clip. So I only read one chapter of it, but yeah, that's it. So that's all I have to show you guys. And thank you so much for watching. And I'll look forward to seeing you in Summer Colorween.